No, for me, it's not important at all anyhow. So, and if someone talks about us and hasn't done the research anyhow, then it doesn't really matter. So I'm not over the moon if someone praises us who is not really knowing what we're doing, and the other around the same. So if someone says that we don't have the right anyhow to play in Premier League level, 97 points last season, title win, championship. Yeah, want to see which team has done this anyhow and doesn't deserve. So we didn't want our place in the lottery anyhow. We have earned unbelievable hard. And my feeling is, really, with all respect to all the other clubs, but my feeling is, if a self-funding club on this level is able to win the title in the championship with 97 points and cut the championship into pieces, self-funding club, yeah, without external money anyhow, and the club who has earned probably more money in the last 3.5 years than any other club in Western Europe, and is capable to play such a football anyhow, and the best season of best record of the season, no one earns more the right to play on the top level. Yes, and if someone says, yeah, sometimes when you want to get your message across and you have to provoke a little bit, or you didn't have done your research, I'm not annoyed, and it's just part of the business. Sometimes someone wants to provoke a little bit, or wants you have to sell your news, or you have to sell your judgment a little bit, and then overdoing a little bit and provoking a little bit. And I think each and everyone who has more knowledge and information about what we are doing and what we're trying to achieving and looks a bit under the surface is just praising us. I think we had 2 years ago also with Ian Abrahams from Talksport. He was criticizing us 2 years ago. Meanwhile, he's a big fan of our model anyhow, and he values it and he likes it anyhow, because meanwhile he's got all the information what we're doing here. And it's always the same. We want to convince just with our work and what we're doing, and not we don't need to convince someone who doesn't know what we're doing here. So that's not important for me, and also not an extra motivation either. Well, we let's be honest, we are the only self-funding club on this level. That means we will be the underdog in more or less each and every game, or nearly each and every game. Yeah, perhaps against the promoted side with us, anyhow, you could say, okay, it's more or less on the same level. But that's it. And anyhow, and then I'm also not because quite often the people like the underdog. Yeah, there must be some people who want to provoke and say, no, the underdog has to win each and every game. So just to have a opinion, and everyone says, oh, he's a great personality and he's special anyhow, so it's not important at all. So we know that we are the underdog, but we don't try to make more out of us as we are, but also not less anyhow. So we want to be competitive during the season. In the end, yes, we will see after 38 game days, not before, where we are, and that's just the point. And I'm pretty sure that in the end, yeah, this team, whatever the outcome is, but I think everyone has a connection with the yellow shirt, and I'm pretty sure that this team, and my gut feeling is like this, will have done everyone proud who is connected with the yellow shirt. Yeah, first of all, we are really really happy that we have him, and we have worked on this business for quite a long time, even since a few weeks, because we are fully convinced of Ren and his qualities. A young player full of potential, and he has proven this already, or even on Premier League level for top class side, and also has a few appearances also in the European competition. So I'm pretty happy that we have him. But like always with a young player, so we are always a bit careful. It's not like after 2 days he's in, he will wear the captain armband and cut the Premier League for us into pieces. More like it's also for him. It's sometimes even a bit easier to play with a top class side, and anyhow, and instead of bringing or being immediately then one of the best performers in the side anyhow, who is just promoted. So for that we have to be a bit careful, but we are fully convinced of his strengths, and it was definitely also a position we were looking at in the last weeks, because we just have one natural left fullback in our squad with Dimitrios Giannoulis, and I think it was quite important to bring another fullback in. Brandon plays, although he's right-footed, regularly on the left back position, but of course he can also play the right fullback position. I think I'm quite happy that we have him right now, and was important key piece of our business during this window. Christos is an unbelievable, interesting young player, and he was totally worth also the money that we spent on him, because he's one of the hottest prospects on the winger position in whole Europe in his age, and it's never a guarantee that he has the potential to be one day one of the best wingers in the world. He has the potential to do this, because he's quick, he delivers end products, he can score, he can assist. He's there with runnings in behind, great character anyhow, and many, many skills we like about him. This was the reason why many, many clubs in Europe were chasing him. If there would be a guarantee that he does the next steps anyhow on the best level, yeah, he would be worth whatever, £100 million, yeah, because it's the price and for the best wingers in the world. So it's never a guarantee. So for even with him, so we have to be careful. We have to make sure that we don't bring him too early in contention anyhow, once he's not prepared anyhow. So I have to make sure that sometimes the players need a little bit to adapt anyhow. Let's be honest, he came from a league anyhow. He has also played for a big club, and that's a sign also of his potential, but not from one of the best leagues in the world, if I'm honest. So the intensity and the speed and the pace anyhow is, of course, here a bit different in, with all respect to the Greek football and in comparison to the Premier League here right now. And we need to give him also a bit time to adapt to this, and I will definitely do this. But he's also in my thoughts. It could be that he is also involved in the games and in the game tomorrow, and it was also no coincidence that he was already in the game day squad. It was not a gift anyhow, but we see his potential. But it's also not like we've signed, for example, Milot Rasica, who has many, many Bundesliga games and lots of experience. We've signed Josh Sargent, who is 2 years older, has already 70 games on Bundesliga level. Of course, they are more the players where you expect, okay, they can even help really in really short term. Christos is more a project who helps in mid and in long term. That doesn't mean in 2 or 3 years anyhow, but it could mean even a few weeks or a few months anyhow. So for that, don't put too much pressure on him, and also too much expectations on him. He will need also a bit time anyhow to shine, and then to use his whole potential. But we work each and every day with him, and it could also be that he's involved in a few minutes even tomorrow. It's definitely a good game and a tough test for us. Bournemouth, they've themselves played several years in a row on Premier League level. It was a bit surprising that 2 years ago they were relegated, and had also good chances to promote back straight away to the Premier League last season. And in general, so they still have a really good squad with many, many individual quality, many, I would say Premier League players. And, they started the season also quite well, not sitting on top of the league, but they're still unbeaten anyhow. And we are pretty, pretty respectful. So it will be a tough test anyhow. There's no doubt about this. But nevertheless, we want to go into the next round.